Hello everyone, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depends on when are you watching this video. My name is Magdalena Urbaniak and today I'm going to talk about microbial degradation of xenobiotics and especially how can we stimulate or accelerate the process, this process by using plant secondary metabolites. However, talking about xenobiotics, please bear in mind that there is a huge number of compounds classified as xenobiotics. Why? Simply because xenobiotic is any substance or any compound that is not naturally produced by organism. Therefore, today I'm going to talk about one specific group of compounds, and this group is called phenoxy herbicides. Phenoxy herbicides such as 2,4-D and MCPA are widely used in agriculture to control broadleaf weeds. Although the application has helped to increase the yield and the value of crops, they are also recognized as a source of emerging environmental contamination. Their extensive use may promote contamination of soil, surface and groundwater, and in this way led to increased inhibition of plant development and soil toxicity. Hence, there is an urgent need to identify nature-based methods that enable us to remove those compounds from the environment in a safe way. One approach to remove phenoxy herbicides from the soil environment is via degradation by soil microbiota in the process called biodegradation. This is achieved mostly by bacteria harboring specific functional genes which are involved in the phenoxy herbicide degradation pathways. Variety of bacteria have been isolated and proved to harbor functional genes responsible for degradation of phenoxy herbicides. However, degradation process in soil can be very slow, especially under changing environmental conditions. Another promising and rapidly growing method of cleaning contaminated soil is phytoremediation. Phytoremediation is a bioremediation process that uses various types of plants to remove, transfer, stabilize, or destroy contaminants in the soil and the groundwater. The ability to take up pollutants from the soil is highly dependent on the plant species, its morphology, and physiology. Plants play also a key role in the soil ecosystems by stabilizing the soil structure and by serving as primary sources of organic matter and energy, which stimulate soil microbial activity. However, they are not only the contributors in the efficient phytoremediation of organic contaminants. Due to existing interactions between plant roots, root exudates, soil and microorganisms, it has been proposed that the most effective method for the remediation of contaminated soil may be by using microbe-assisted phytoremediation process, and this process in short we called rhizoremediation. It was hypothesized that the activity of the rhizospheric microorganisms is stimulated by plant secondary metabolites excreted by plants to the rhizosphere. Plant secondary metabolites may have a profound impact on the biodegradation of xenobiotics. They increase the bioavailability of organic compounds, they stimulate the growth of the biomass of soil bacteria that positively affect the growth and the condition of plants in the presence of organic pollutants, and we call these bacteria plant growth promoting bacteria, and they also stimulate the biodegradation activity of rhizospheric microorganisms. Consequently, we believe that interaction between soil microorganisms and plants and plant secondary metabolites can be used as effective tool to stimulate biodegradation of organic pollutants. We hypothesize that plant secondary metabolites, structurally similar to xenobiotics, can enhance or stimulate the process of pollutants biodegradation. To test this hypothesis, we have selected two pairs of herbicide and plant secondary metabolite having similar chemical structure, and it is 2,4-D and ferulic acid and MCPA and syringic acid. Our results confirmed the enhanced number of functional degradative genes in samples amended with plant secondary metabolite. What is more, we observe higher removal of herbicide MCPA in variants with plant secondary metabolite. However, this effect was mostly visible for the lower concentrations of the herbicide. We also noted the decreased phytotoxicity of soil when the plant secondary metabolite was applied. In the case of plants condition, as you can see here, the addition of the herbicide together with plant secondary metabolite, in this case MCPA and syringic acid, decreased the toxic effect of the herbicide applied solely. To conclude, application of plant secondary metabolites enhance the removal of the herbicides through stimulation of bacteria to degrade the given xenobiotic, decrease soil phytotoxicity, and also improve plant's condition. I would like to thank you for the time you spent watching this presentation. I hope that information it contains was useful for you. Thank you once again and have a nice day.